So there's no real correct answer to this quiz. If you really don't like money, I guess you could prefer not to be paid at all. The closest thing to a correct answer is that it depends. And it depends on how you interpret the meaning of biweekly. We could look that up in the dictionary to decide how we should interpret it. And if we look up biweekly in the dictionary, what we see is the definition of biweekly, which is right here. It says happening every 2 weeks is the first definition. The second definition is happening twice a week. If you have the first definition, you'd rather be paid weekly, assuming you like more money. If you have the second definition, you'd rather be paid biweekly. Maybe that's the problem with paper dictionaries, that they're not very precise because they're old things. Let's look up a more modern dictionary. Let's see what Wiktionary has to say about this. So here's the Wiktionary entry for biweekly. And if we scroll down, we can see that it has two meanings: occurring once every 2 weeks, occurring twice a week. This is chiefly in the UK. The American dictionary didn't seem to think that. It seemed to think both definitions occurred in both countries. So this is a pretty big problem. If we wrote a computer program and the program was doing our payroll and had to decide what it meant to pay someone biweekly, we'd want to make sure that it understood that the same way the programmer did. So that's one important reason why we need to invent new languages like Python to program computers rather than using natural languages that we already understand. And that's because we don't really understand languages like English or Mandarin, that there's lots of things that different people will understand different ways. And this happens at the granularity of words like biweekly. It also happens in complete sentences where there are many different ways to interpret the same phrase. Another reason we don't use natural languages for programming is that natural languages are actually very verbose. To write a program, we need to describe exactly what the computer should do in very precise sequence of steps. If we had to describe all those details using a natural language, that would require a huge amount of text. So we'll see soon that with a programming language like Python, we only need a few lines of code to describe a complicated thing and describe in a very precise step-by-step way. So I want you to think about, as we write programs in this class, how much more detail you'd need to actually describe in English precisely how to do what we're describing with a few lines of Python code.